Hello children, today's topic is watercolors, watercolor design. So this is the first time I'm recording my voice with the video. So let's see how it goes and give me your feedbacks. Okay, so we start off with drawing triangles and a series of straight lines, but the lines are in rhythmic order. I have recorded this video in high speed because it was too long. Yeah, the triangles seem to be forming a rhythmic pattern which takes the path of the eye all around the page. Yeah, we start coloring with a very mild orange diluted color. Please note that in watercolors it is better to start off with medium shades first. It's not a rule, but it is what I feel personally, because we can judge the tonal values. For example, we can judge on gray how much dark we need or how much light color we need to put. So if you put just a dark color first, you may not get the idea that what shade you need to put, lighter or darker. So it's better to start off with gray tones or middle tones. So here I'm trying to put the lighter shades on one side and the darker shades towards the left. Now, darker shades are indicated in watercolors by cool colors, because cool colors give us a dark feeling. So towards the left I will be putting more of cool shades. Like, what are the cool colors? Yeah, I think it's green, blue, and violet. That is what you feel it is. Oh, yeah, you are right. But also you can add gray as cool, because gray is a neutral. So it can go anyway. It can go in cool as well as warm color. Yeah, I'm putting in the darker shades of the warm next to the lighter shades. Yeah, turn the board as you need to get a more finished look for your design. Like, you know, if you use turn the board as you need, you will not struggle with the finishing. Finishing in the sense, the border work has to be very sharp and presentable. Like, there are marks for sharp border work also, and then there are marks for application also, color application. What do you mean by application? Application means the way you prepare your color and how you apply it on the paper. For example, if you take too much water, then the colors will be very light, you know, very diluted and very dull, which will not give a pleasant look to your design. So you need to prepare your color well first. So how to prepare watercolors? See, in watercolors, transparent, we don't use white and black. Actually, although some artists or some people may want to use black, it's okay. But actually, we don't use black and white in watercolors because they are a transparent media. So you're not justifying the medium if you are using black or white. You know, that would be like poster colors. So I'm making use of black, but I'm making use of black in only in the corners, like because our topic is watercolor stained glass design. So by using black on the corners, I'm giving an effect of stained glass. It gives a feeling of depth and it uplifts the element very well. Yeah, one more thing, when you're putting in the black shade, don't put it very early because you just have to wait around 30 to 40 seconds and then you apply the black shade on the corner, which will spread automatically. You don't need to scribble it with the brush, So if you wait, if you keep your timing in watercolors, it's definitely going to turn out very good. But if you hurry, you will make mistakes and all the color will merge into each other because watercolor, as I have named the topic also aquarelle. I have named the topic aquarelle. Aquarelle means watercolor only, but what I'm trying to say here is that aquarelle colors, they are very fluid. So they are not like poster colors. So you need to have a great amount of control on your brush and the amount of water that you take, the timing, and then it's going to be fine. It takes practice. So first I started with orange, then I went towards lighter red, then towards the brown. Now from brown I've gone towards green, which is a cool color. From green I'm moving towards blue. Yeah, and I'm also making shades of that color at the same time, not just one green and one blue like that. So gradually even the shading creates a rhythm. It's not just the drawing. You may think that drawing is only important, drawing is only important, but coloring is equally important because when you shade the whole topic in a particular way, it creates a rhythm. That coloring gives you a direction, like the path of your eye, it moves according to the coloring on the page. So even coloring is important because rhythm is the most important fundamental. Whether it's singing, whether it's dancing, whether it's sculpture, there is rhythm is present in different forms everywhere. And without rhythm, your design would be dead. There's no movement, there's no life. Rhythm can be in drawing the figures also, in the placement of the figures also. You have to be very careful at elementary intermediate level how you place the elements. If you place it wrongly, there will be no rhythm and you'll lose your marks. Yeah, I'm gradually coloring the darker parts. I'm making them even more darker gradually. But keep in mind at the same time that as you're making it dark also, it should be transparent. The darkest color used also should be transparent because you're using a transparent media. So if it's not transparent, also you can lose your marks because you're not fully justifying the watercolors, the transparent colors. Yeah, and we're almost coming to the end of this design now. But as I told you, I have increased the running the speed of the video. Otherwise, it would be too long and boring for you to watch. So I don't want you to get bored. I'm just giving the finishing touches here. With red, there was a red missing a lot. So now it's almost over now. And yeah, that's it. just a little bit of red, yellows here and there to bring out the elements. You tidy your paper. If there are any spots, just wipe them off. And we are done.